Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you few very interesting questions based on Little Endian and Big Endian computers. In my previous videos, I have already explained how exactly Little Endian and Big Endian computer stores data on memory. In this video, I'll explain you all those things by examples so that you can have fair enough idea about how exactly Little Endian and Big Endian computer works. Let us see the first question over here. So if you observe first question, then here we are given with 2 bytes of data. First byte is 10101100. In binary data is given. So one byte is having 8 bits of data. So this is MSB, most significant byte of this data. And this is LSB, means last significant byte, or you can say least significant byte of data. How it will be stored in Little Endian format, that is the question. So whenever you have any data that you need to store it in Little Endian or Big Endian, at a time, first of all, you need to identify the address. So if you see options A, B, C, D, so in that we are having two address, 0x, then 4 times 0, and 0x, then 0001. Now, you might be having question like, what is the meaning of 0x? 0x means the data which is given over here, that is there in form of hexadecimal data. So this first address, that is 0000 hex. That is how data is there, right? So this is address, but that is given in form of hexadecimal. So in computer, this is also one way by which you can represent hexadecimal data, 0x, right? So this is my first address, that is 4 times 0 hex, and second address, that is 0001 hex. So that is how two addresses are there. Now, in Little Endian, we need to store this data. So remember, in Little Endian, first you will be storing LSB, or you can say at lower address, we need to store lower byte, and at higher address we need to store higher byte in Little Endian. So here, my dear students, at lower address we will be storing lower byte. Lower byte is 0011 0011. That is how lower byte is there. And at higher address you will be storing higher byte, that is 10101100. So that is how you will be storing data in Little Endian format. As if same question is there for Big Endian, then remember one thing. When you store data, first you will be storing MSB. Or you can say at lower address, you will have to store higher byte, and at higher address, you will have to store lower byte. So as if question is there based on Big Endian, then in Big Endian, at this address, first you will be storing higher byte, that is 10101100. And at higher address, you will be storing lower byte, so that is 0011 0011. So here, this is how you would be storing data in Big Endian, right? So here, you see, question is there based on Little Endian. So what will be our correct option? At 4 times 0, data is 0011 0011, and at this address, data is 10101100. So this is our correct option, right, for this Little Endian structure. And as if question is there based on Big Endian, then you see, at lower address we are storing 10101100, and at this 0001 hex address we are storing 0011 0011. So that is available over here. So this would be your answer for Big Endian. But question is there based on Little Endian, so this is correct option for this. Now I'm going to explain you second question. So in second question, you see a hexadecimal number that is given. So in hex, number is given now, and we are storing that from the memory location 1000 hex in Little Endian format. what will be the value occupied by memory locations 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003 hex? That is the question. So first of all, we need to write down addresses, right? So here, first of all, let me write the addresses 1000 hex, then second address is 1001 hex, then third address is 1002 hex, then fourth address is 1003 hex. Now, here we need to store that in little endian format. So this data that we need to store. So first of all, you need to bisect this data in terms of byte, right? The reason is at one location you can store one byte of data. So you see here, this is my first byte C3, then second byte is 4B, third byte is E8, and fourth byte is 77. And remember, this C3, that is MSB, most significant byte. And this last one, that is 77 hex, that is LSB. So in little endian, at first address you will be storing LSB, right? Or you can say in little endian, when you store the data at that time at lower address, lower byte is getting stored. So at 1000 hex you will be storing 77 hex. After that you will be storing E8 hex. After that you will be storing 4B hex. After that you will be storing C3 hex. Right, that is how the data that we need to store in little endian structure. And as if question is based on big endian, then also you should know how to solve that. So in big endian, remember this, first you will be storing MSB, or you can say at lower address we need to store MSB. So lower address is 1000, at that address you will be storing C3 hex. Then at 1001, you will have to store 4B. Then at 1002, you will have to store E8 hex. Then at 1003 hex, you will have to store 77 hex. Right. So that is how in big endian, we need to store data. Now, let us move on to third question. So in third question, question is in big endian system, the computer stores data in which order, right? So we need to read the options over here. Option A is MSB of data in lowest memory address of data unit. Yes, see, in big endian, MSB should be stored at lower address, you see, right? You see, MSB that is getting stored at lower address. So this option is correct. Still, we need to read other options, right? LSB of data in lowest memory address of data unit? No, this is false. MSB of data in highest memory address unit? No, that is also false. LSB of data in highest memory address? Yes, you see, in big endian, LSB, you see 77, that we are storing at highest address, right? You see here highest address is 0001, at which we are storing LSB, you can observe. So LSB that is stored at highest address, right? So two options are correct over here for this question. So sometimes that happens, like two options are correct, but it is not like you can have only one option. Remember this. So that is how tricky questions can be there. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if anything that you would like to share, place that in the comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.